Karen, are you there? There it is.
Oh, Andy. Now you're going to have to get a new window and everything.
Well, at least it's only the windshield.
Yeah.
She smashed out the van windows, too.
Oh,
she didn't miss the car. She just lost it. Come in, and I made her some popcorn, and she just threw it all over the place. And then she grabbed our pictures and started smashing them off the mirror, the wardrobe mirror.
Oh,
I'm surprised it didn't break.
Yeah.
And that's when I said, I'm bailing. And then she started getting crazy, calling Nancy Pelosi and all them, and chewing them out.
So she's intoxicated. She's kind of had some of her prescribed medication along with alcohol tonight. They were a little upset about the election results.
And one more thing.
Yes, ma'am.
If you don't vote red, your children are being indoctrinated to be Hitler's youth number two. And sexually indoctrinated. So you vote red or blue, but if you vote blue, I feel really sorry for you.
You all set? You need me to help you close that? Okay.
Yep. Here we go. Let's put up the picture of the destruction of this Karen. This individual engaged in criminal conduct, and it was, you know, insane. So a few things here. The Karen in question decided to commit vandalism because she did not like the outcome of an election. Understand this now. Because of an election, she decided to engage in criminal conduct. Well, what did the officer do? Well, he provided assistance. He was very nice, cordial. It did not make him upset. The fact that the individual was intoxicated did not cause him to say, hey, we're going to lock you up for public intoxication. The spirit, the personality, the attitude, completely different. I want you to change variables just for a minute here. Okay, let's say it's not a Karen. Let's say it's a black male. Black male is upset over the election. He decides to destroy property. Police come to said location. They see an intoxicated African-American male. This African-American male opens the door and starts talking directly to the officer about what the cop needs to do with his own life. Do you think the officer turns around and says to the black male, hey, listen, can I help you? You know, let me come up here and help you out. Yeah. No, of course not. Never has happened. Have you ever seen it before? Never. We routinely see it when you change the individuals. That is all the proof you need to understand either hyper aggressive bias or implicit bias. As I have always said, it doesn't matter which one it is, because at the end of it, the impact is the same. Ricky, thoughts on this?
Yeah, you know, just preferential treatment that they get because, yeah, you're absolutely right. If that was me or you, we would be in jail. Somebody invited her in and gave her some hot buttery over red and vodka popcorn
right
there and bust somebody's mother. But I want to just encourage everybody, when you have a Karen incident, take your phone out and film immediately.
Yes.
Because you have to continue to film, embarrass, prosecute, and hold people accountable for their actions. And if she would have broke the windows out of my car, I would have took a jackhammer and flipped that trailer over.
Just me thinking about the imagery of that, it makes me chuckle.